Hey folks, my name is Samuel. I'm a PhD student at MIT, and today I'm going to show you how to ace all of your exams during your exam periods. It was midnight on New Year's Eve. I was sitting completely alone in the university's library, desperately trying to catch up and study with everything that I needed to know for the exam period just 3 weeks ahead of me. I could see the fireworks outside, I could hear my fellow classmates cheer and celebrate, but I was just completely desperate, really trying to catch up with everything. It was a particularly challenging semester for me because I had been completely focused on research in my PhD applications, and I was also getting ready to move to the US to start my master thesis at Harvard and MIT. So in an effort to finish all of my classes one semester early, I had taken 7 rather challenging classes, most of which, to be completely honest with you, had never even attended. Here is my complete strategy for how I managed to ace every single one of these exams. Tip number 1, create your battle plan. Think about all of your exams and your deadlines as battles that you need to win. And if you just start fighting without having a complete strategy and thought through plan, you'll most likely lose at least some of these battles. Already 2 months before my final exams, I made an exact and detailed schedule of exactly which date I would have which exam and which deadline due. So you can see my calendar right over here. Everything that's marked in red are essentially some kind of exams or deadlines, or as you can see, some PhD interviews. By having this complete overview over here for January and also for December, I could make a winning battle strategy just to make sure that I have time for studying and preparing for every single deadline. Here you can see that I spent the first half of December just going through my PhD applications, which obviously was a lot of work to prepare, and it was only around December 21st that I could really start studying. So in early December, I sat down and made an exact plan of every single course that I was taking, how many days it would take me to study for the exam. You can see that schedule over here. Every single course had a certain number of days that I would need at least to get everything done. And then I just allocated my time. You can see that over here in gray for the end of December and also for January. I had an exact schedule for every single day, knowing which subject I had to study. And that way I could ensure that I would get everything done in time for all of my exams. The key here is leaving room for wrong estimates. So if you have, for example, 9 chapters to study in 5 days, you should plan to finish them in just 3 days, because most likely you're gonna get stuck with some chapter or some problem that you don't really understand, and you will need an extra buffer day just to cover all of that. So that means you finish in 4 days, and then you have 1 extra day just to review and quiz yourself. This last part is super important because it will allow you to uncover all the gaps in the knowledge that you have. So I recommend either explaining everything to yourself or maybe to a fellow student who can then ask questions about why certain things are the way they are. Also, sometimes you're going to have back-to-back exams and then you don't really have time to just study the day before. For example, I had a particularly hard exam in statistics for data science that you can see over here on the 29th, and I knew it would take me roughly 12 days to study for it. But since I had a whole bunch of exams just the days and weeks before, I already got started on January 6th making sure that I pre-study everything, so later I would have time to do the rest. Before moving on to tip number 2, make sure to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel so you don't miss all the new content that's coming up soon. Tip number 2, study using active recall and spaced repetition as your memorization techniques. Countless studies have shown that these are the most effective ways to transfer all the knowledge right into your long-term memory. You should do this even if you study STEM, where memorization may not seem as obviously important as it may seem when you study history or geography. If there is one thing that I really regret from my undergraduate studies, it's the fact that I never really put sufficient effort into long-term memorizing all the stuff that I acquired through years and years of hard work. Simply highlighting or reading your text or even making notes is just not enough to memorize long-term. So I made a whole separate video about the most effective ways to study. You can check it out over here or just find a link in the description afterwards. Tip number 3, you should study in groups. Studying in groups can be super helpful, but only if you find the right people to work with. So my previous example of statistics and data science was a really hard class, and given that I hadn't really attended most of the lectures, I had a really hard time understanding all the concepts just based on the book. Luckily, I found a great person to work with. We had a similar understanding of the subject, we motivated each other, and made sure to hold each other accountable for getting everything done in time. The key to having a very productive study group is making sure that, first of all, you don't study together with your best friends, because let's face it, you're going to end up chit-chatting all the time instead of just working. Also, you should make sure to not study with people who are either significantly more or less knowledgeable than you are, because you will have a hard time working at the same pace. Also, you should avoid people who are either completely disorganized or stress you out, because they will just mess up your carefully crafted battle plan. If you study for a STEM course and your studies involve a lot of problem solving, you can check out my video about problem solving strategies over here. Again, I put the link in the description. Tip number 4 is optimize your nutrition. Optimizing nutrition is super important because while you're studying, it is very easy to fall for the trap of either eating very irregularly or just eating some random junk food. But the problem with this is it's just going to lower your ability to perform, and once you notice that you're not able to memorize things so easily or understand things so quickly anymore, you might start panicking and make things even worse than that. At the same time, you don't want to waste too much time preparing every single meal, unless of course cooking helps you to relax and therefore become more productive afterwards. So in my case, looking back at the calendar over here, you can see that I had 2 meal prep sessions per week. So one of them would be on Tuesday and one of them on Saturday, always at 8 p.m. And during that time, I would cook some brown rice, some sweet potatoes, some vegetables, chicken, tofu, not exactly fine dining, but it was super efficient because I would just put all of these large quantities of food in my fridge. And every time I would get hungry, within 5 minutes, I could have a nutritionally complete meal. And it's way cheaper than eating out or ordering food every single time. Tip number 5 is sleep enough. This is possibly the most severe mistake that students make during their exam sessions. When you're preparing for exams, you should actually increase the amount of time that you sleep. So during these 2 months of December and January, at least 90% of the nights, I got at least 7 hours of sleep, because I'm fully aware that for every hour of sleep that I miss, I'm gonna lose at least 1.5 to maybe even 2 hours of productive work over the coming days. While you're studying, it is super important that you always operate at peak productivity. I know it's tempting to pull all-nighters and panic all the time, but there are so many studies that have clearly shown that if you get the right amount of sleep and have a regular sleep schedule, you're going to perform so much better academically. This particular study shows how the quantity and quality of sleep that you get in the month leading up to the exam is actually more important than the quality of sleep that you have just the night before the exam. So make sure that you sleep well the entire month before the exams. Also, a lot of studies have shown that lack of sleep really decreases your ability to memorize and to recall all the information that you have memorized in the past. And also, it significantly decreases your attention span, which obviously is the worst thing that can happen while you're trying to study. Tip number 6 is exercise. I know it is very tempting after some very exhausting study sessions to just scroll through TikTok or watch some Netflix, but this doesn't really allow your brain to fully recharge and recover from all the time that you spend staring at the screen or reading some textbooks. Having a look back at my calendar, you can see that on Mondays, on Tuesdays, and on Fridays, I would work out. Usually around 10 p.m. I would go to the gym until midnight, and on Sundays in the morning, I would go for a run. These were definitely the 2 most stressful months in my entire life. If I had missed just one single exam, I wouldn't have been able to move to the US and start at Harvard and MIT. But luckily, by following all of the 6 steps that I gave you, I managed to ace every single one of these exams, and just 2 weeks later, I moved to the US where I have been living ever since. If you're studying anything STEM related, you can join me in a real study session here at MIT by watching this video over here. I'm gonna put the link in the description. Finally, as you have surely all experienced, sometimes it can be really hard to stay focused during your entire study sessions. So one of the best ways to stay productive and keep focused all the time is with Rise, the sponsor of this video. Rise is a smart time tracking app that improves your ability to focus by keeping track of all of the work that you're doing in real time. You can just let it run in the background and receive a detailed report of exactly how productive you were throughout the day. It is even smart enough to differentiate between the different types of websites that you visit, so it can easily tell whether you're looking at an educational website, actually studying, or whether you're wasting your time watching some TikTok videos. Depending on the type of work you do, you can easily create custom categories that will allow you to get a personalized overview of exactly how productive you are and how you spend your time. Also, since it is humanly impossible to be productive 100% of all the time, it also helps you time your study breaks, and even more importantly, make sure that you get back to being productive as soon as these study breaks are over. You can try out Rise for free and boost your productivity. The first 1,000 people to use my affiliate code or the link in the description will get a 25% discount on the first 3 months of their Rise membership. Make sure to check out my videos about the best study methods over here and my video about problem-solving strategies over here. Also, if you want to join me for a real study session in STEM, you can check out my video over here. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and turn on the notifications. I wish you best of luck with all of your exams, and I'll see you next time. Take care.